A very good morning to my dear students. Let's start our computer science class. I think you all are safe in your home. Let's start our class. So before that, I am introducing a new chapter to you, which is encoding schemes and number system. We have completed chapter 1 of NCERT textbook. This is chapter 2, encoding schemes and number system. So in this encoding scheme and number system, we are discussing some data manipulation takes place in our computer. Have you ever wondered when we are pressing our keys in keyboard, how can it is translated into computer? How the computer can understand it? Have you ever think about it? Yes, I think all students will think about it. Because our computer uses low-level language or binary representations, but we are inputting some characters by using keyboards. We are inputting A, B, C, D, or hello, or have you ever wondered like that we inputting. So how can the computer knows what we are inputting it? So that will be understand by you when you study this chapter. So in this chapter, we will introduce text interpretation by the computer. Text interpretation means how can the text is converted into computer recognizable form. We are entering some text like who, how, what, how this text is converted to computer recognizable form. This is our encoding schemes chapter mainly focused with. So we are using binary representation in computer. You know that we studied in first chapter that computer will know only binary number, which is zeros and one. So when we are entering some character, then it also must be converted into binary representation, right? Otherwise computer will not understand our characters. So let's find an example. Here in this example, when the key A is pressed in figure 2.1, they are specifying when the key A is pressed, it is internally mapped to a decimal value 64, which is the conversion to its equivalent binary value for the computer understand. I know you don't understand this what I am telling. Here they are telling that when the key A is pressed, what happened? We are pressing the key A, but computer cannot identify this A. Then what happens? First, this A is converted to decimal value. Decimal value means the values which are used by us. We are using 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Decimal systems are followed by us. In mathematics, we are using decimal system. So the corresponding decimal value of A is 65. We will tell why it is 65, that in next section. So it is 65. So but this decimal value is also not understandable by the computer. So this decimal value again converted into its equivalent binary value. Binary value means it contains only zeros and one. Then computer will understand these zeros and one. So understand, when we are pressing A, first its decimal value is formed, which is 65. Then this decimal value is converted to binary equivalent. So this is what is happening. If we are pressing letter A, corresponding decimal value 65 is formed, and corresponding binary number 01000001 is formed, which is understandable to the computer. Similarly, when Hindi A is, even if we are using Hindi keyboard and Hindi A is pressed, its hexadecimal value, instead of decimal, it is mapped to hexadecimal value. We will study this later. What is decimal, binary and hexadecimal? Don't worry about it. So it is converted to 0905. Its equivalent form is this. So this is known as encoding. Encoding. So the mechanisms of converting data into an equivalent cipher using specific code is called encoding. Simply, we are converting one data into its equivalent specific code or its equivalent binary representation, which is known as encoding. So what is encoding? We are converting our data or our input or any data into other types of data or equivalent specific code, which is known as encoding. So previously we told the value A has 65 or value of R has 0905 and so on. So how can this possible? So this has been possible because of some standard encoding schemes. We will use in all world, we are using some standard encoding scheme. For each letter, corresponding decimal value will be there, and corresponding decimal value, their corresponding binary numbers will be there. So there are some encoding schemes are there. Numerals and symbols are encoded and converted into unique code, which is known as encoding schemes. So we have to discuss what an encoding schemes. Then in this chapter we will study cipher, the term cipher, equivalent cipher. Our data is converted to equivalent cipher. Cipher means something converted to a code which is hidden to the user. We cannot know which is the code. So it is also known as encryption. Encryption, you all heard the term encryption in our WhatsApp. There are some two-way standard encryption mechanisms are there. So in this encryption, data are converted to equivalent code, but other users will not identify it, what is the data, and send to the receiver. So when we are sending a data, it is converted to its equivalent cipher representation, and this cipher is transferred to the receiver. So no one cannot identify what the data that we had sent to the receiver. So this is for security, these encryption mechanisms are provided. So simply don't worry about it. Simply cipher means something converted to a coded form. It is hidden. We cannot know, it is hidden data. So we discussed encoding. Encoding means we are converting our input into some specified code. This specified code is hidden to the user. This is known as cipher, or this mechanism is known as encoding. The mechanisms of converting data into equivalent cipher is known as encoding. There are many encoding mechanisms are used. First one is, normally we are using this first one, which is known as American Standard Code for Information Interchange, which is also known as ASCII, ASCII value, you heard. And second type is Indian Script Code for Information Interchange, which is known as ISCII, instead of ASCII, ISCII. Then next is Unicode. These three types of encoding mechanisms are used. They are ASCII. First is ASCII, then ISCII, then Unicode. So let's discuss what's an ASCII. ASCII is American Standard Code for Information Interchange. Its full name is American Standard Code for Information Interchange. In 1960s, our computers have no way of communicating with each other because our keyboards are different, our operating systems are different, our devices are different. So it is difficult to communicate with two computers. Hence, the need of common standard evolved. Need of common standard. So if we are using different types of devices, but it must follow some common standards. When we follow this common standard, so two devices can communicate with each other. For this purpose, encoding scheme is developed. First developed is ASCII. Now also we are using ASCII representation normally. Initially, ASCII used 7 bits to represent characters. 7 bits, but there are 2 bits for binary digits, zeros and ones. So our character in English, our keyboard contains English keyboard that can be encoded into 7-bit ASCII codes. That means 2 raised to 7 equal to 128 codes are there. These are fixed values. We cannot change this ASCII value. So 2 raised to 7, initially 7 characters are used, only 2 binary digits are there. So 2 raised to 7 combinations are possible, which is equal to 128. So let's look the some ASCII codes in this box. ASCII value is for only English characters or keyboard characters. So let's look. Here capital A has value of 65. This is fixed. 65 is the decimal value. We have to convert this decimal value into binary digits. Not we, computer will convert. Then only computer can understand. 2 raised to 7, that means 128 values are possible. B 66, capital C 67. And small letter A 97, small letter B 98, and so on. According to the A order, first A, small value for capital A, higher value for small letter A. And some characters have also some decimal value, hash. Our keyboard characters will have these ASCII values. So this is the ASCII code. You have to study this ASCII code at least for some characters. If you studied capital A, then you can study capital B, capital C, and so on. So capital A, value of capital A is 65. Value of small letter A equal to 97, and so on. Then if we encode the word data, then first it is converted to decimal value and then it is converted to binary value. So data, for D the value is 68. So D is 68 and its equivalent binary code is, binary code will be in the form of 7 bit. It is this. We can study in next portion how decimal values are converted into binary digits. Don't worry about it. And next is A. What is the value of A? A value of A equal to 65. It is converted to binary form and we will get this value. And value of capital T. Here capital T is not specified. I equal to 75, then 73, then J will be 74 and so on. The value of capital T is 84. Its corresponding binary digit is this. Again, the value of A is 65. The corresponding binary digit is this. So, by using this representation, computer will identify what is our data. So, for D, if you are entering D or if you are pressing D, then 68 is the decimal number form and this is the binary code form. So, these binary codes will be understandable to the computer and the computer will process our information. In this way, our values are converted into binary forms and computer will understand. Next is Indian script code for information interchange or ISCII. In ASCII, already 128 codes are possible. That means for English, our keyboard characters, all our keyboard characters are in ASCII because only 128 possible datas will be possible or 128 binary codes will be possible. And it is uses 7-bit representation. But our Indian language have some other language, other characters also. So to represent our Indian languages too, Indian system is developed which is known as ISCII, which is a 8-bit code representation. So 8-bit code means 2 raised to 8 equal to 256 characters are possible. In ASCII 7-bit code we use as 2 raised to 7 equal to 128 is possible. Here 2 raised to 8 equal to 256 characters. We can represent 256 characters. So in this 128 characters are in the same of ASCII code. So our capital A, capital B all are same as ASCII code. In addition to this, our additional language character set, our Indian language contains some aksharas like aksharamala. Some aksharas are there for this additional 120. So in this 256, 128 is used for same representation as that of ASCII. Remaining there are 128 characters are possible. These 128 characters are our Indian language characters which are known as aksharas. So up to 160 to 255 represents our Indian language, that means aksharas. So this is the Indian system. In ASCII code we can possible 128 characters, only 128 characters. In ISCII code 256 characters are present. In this we can represent Indian language too. So how can we calculate this number of characters? In ASCII 7 bit are used. 7 bit means 7 binary digit are used. So 2 raised to 7 equal to 128 characters is possible. In ISCII 8 characters are used, 8 bits are used, so 2 raised to 8 equal to 256 characters are possible. So next is Unicode. We can explain Unicode in the next class. Thank you and have a nice day.